A simple stroll along the sea in Jaffa, but for Menashe Levy, the end of a long and searing journey. 12 years ago, he was here, in the bustling streets of Ethiopia's capital. 4 years ago, here, in the tough conditions of an Ethiopian prison. And now here, a free man who went to prison for years for crimes he says he didn't commit. Addis Ababa, 2007. Ethiopia is on the cusp of an economic boom. Levy, a building contractor in Israel, tries his luck in Ethiopia and succeeds.
I make a company, road and building construction, that my company was a big company, 6,500 Ethiopian, and I build a lot of main road in Ethiopia.
There were parades for the projects and ribbons cut, but then, charges of three crimes, a trial Levy and his supporters say was unfair. Levy suspects, masterminded by his competitors. Even before the trial was completed, Levy was sent to prison.
I never commit any crime. Not only I never commit a crime, even they put me in prison 4 years without showing one evidence against me.
The Ethiopian embassy in Israel did not respond to a request for comment. Conditions in prison were tough, and much worse. A man from Sudan imprisoned with Levy, convicted for beating an Israeli passenger on an Ethiopian Airlines flight. One day, Levy was in prison, playing backgammon.
I play shishbish with some Turkish guy, and I don't control, and he hit me. A lot of hit, 6-7 times, by wood, big eucalyptus wood, like 2 meters. That he hid in the mosque.
The blows from the Sudanese prisoner landed Levy in the prison hospital for more than 3 years. While there, tragedy struck. Levy's daughter suffered 3 or 4 strokes.
You feel that your daughter's stroke was because of what had happened to you?
I think so. My feeling here, because I think that the heart, she take care about the heart very much. And I think so.
Menashe Levy became a cause celeb. In Washington, in Jerusalem.
There were American senators, there were Americans everywhere, businessmen, or Jewish organizations, Israeli ministers, the Israeli president.
The campaign was led by the Aleph Institute, an organization to support Jewish prisoners worldwide. Even famed lawyer Alan Dershowitz got involved.
When it comes to a Jew being, or anybody really, being improperly imprisoned, you have to use whatever legal and ethical means are available to you to achieve ultimate justice, which is what I think we did, too late and too little, perhaps, in the Menashe Levy case.
A month ago, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu called Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed. Coming to power last year, Ahmed has built a reputation as a reformer. Netanyahu raised Menashe Levy's case.
The Prime Minister, who was amazing, when he got the call, he made the call to the Prime Minister of Ethiopia, which in the end is what brought Menashe home.
And so 3 weeks ago, on July 4th, Menashe Levy walked off the plane onto Israeli soil. Levy is reunited with his daughter, has prayed at the Western Wall, as he looks ahead again to life in the Promised Land.